In the afternoon of Monday, October 25, a Qantas Boeing 737 was operating Flight 888 from Perth to Adelaide. On board were 88 passengers and 6 crew. About an hour into the journey, the crew received a fuel imbalance warning. During completion of the associated checklists, the crew conducted a precautionary shutdown of the affected left engine and decided to divert to Kalgoorlie. As per the flight's planned one engine inoperative diversion scenario, the crew descended to flight level 260. As part of the engine fuel leak checklist, once a leak is confirmed, the auto throttle should be disengaged, the affected thrust lever should be closed, the engine start lever should be moved to the cutoff position, and the pack switch on the affected side should be selected off. This causes the operating pack to regulate to high flow in flight with the flaps up. Passengers reported that the cabin became very hot after the engine was shut down, with everybody asking for water. This is due to the remaining pack being unable to provide sufficient airflow to maintain the normal cabin temperature. The APU, if available, should be started and used to power the generator on the affected side. However, it can't be used for additional bleed air. With an engine providing bleed air, the APU bleed valve cannot be opened, as the APU may sustain damage from back pressure. About 50 minutes after diverting, the aircraft landed in Kalgoorlie. The passengers were ferried on a QantasLink A320 back to Perth, and the aircraft spent several days on the ground while maintenance was performed. Fun fact, the aircraft's name is Kalgoorlie, so what better port to divert to than your namesake? On Saturday morning, the aircraft was returned to service. On Saturday evening, the aircraft was again withdrawn from service and ferried to Sydney as Flight 6001 for further maintenance. On Sunday, October 24, a SpiceJet Dash 8 Q400 was performing Flight 3733 from Hyderabad to Belgaum. Approaching Belgaum, the crew were cleared to approach Runway 26. Instead, the crew circled and landed on Runway 08. The crew then failed to follow the company's procedure in reporting the incident immediately, only doing so after returning to Hyderabad. Data from the flight data recorder and cockpit voice recorder was downloaded, however the CVR recording from the time of the occurrence had been overwritten. The Aircraft Accident Investigations Bureau has launched an investigation into what it's calling a technical error, and both pilots have been removed from the flight crew roster pending the outcome. On Wednesday, October 27, an Ibera A350 was on approach to Madrid after a 9-hour 40-minute flight from Bogota, Colombia. Descending through 1,000 feet, the aircraft struck a large bird, which was identified later as a Cinereus vulture. This type of vulture can have a wingspan up to 3.1 meters, and females can weigh up to 14 kilograms. When the aircraft hit the bird, the aircraft's nose was cracked and the bird became lodged in the damage. The aircraft taxied to the gate with the new addition to the fuselage in situ. The airline reported that replacing the cracked nose panel was a simple procedure, and passengers did not feel the impact. On Thursday, October 28, a Transavia Boeing 737-800 operated Flight 6730 from Seville to Amsterdam. Transavia is a Dutch low-cost airline and wholly owned subsidiary of KLM. Commencing operations in 1966, the airline currently operates an all 737 fleet, with 85 800 series and 4 700 series aircraft. With hubs at Schiphol, Eindhoven, and Rotterdam The Hague airports, Transavia services mainly Europe, with heavy presence in Spain, France, Italy, and Greece, with a few destinations in Africa and the Middle East. With arrivals and departures in full swing, the aircraft landed on runway 18 right and began its 8-kilometer taxi to the gate. During the taxi, the crew were alerted to a fire on the aircraft. The source of the fire was the left main gear. As a precaution, the crew immediately stopped the taxi and ordered an evacuation. 180 passengers and 6 crew, quickly evacuated the aircraft, with some clambering down the trailing edge of the left wing just above the fire. Usually, the evacuation checklist calls for flaps 40 to form a makeshift slide off the back of the wing. However, that wasn't done in this case. Emergency services surrounded the aircraft, and the fire was quickly contained. The destroyed tire was removed and replaced on the taxiway, before the 4.5-year-old aircraft was towed to undergo thorough checks before being returned to service. After last week's Rolls-Royce Boeing Trent 100 sustainable aviation fuel test flight, this Thursday, October 28, Airbus joined the battle for net zero. Partnering with Dassault Aviation, ONERA, the French Ministry of Transports and Safran, Airbus launched the first in-flight study of a single-aisle aircraft running on unblended sustainable aviation fuel. Flying over the Toulouse region, one of the Airbus A319neo's CFM LEAP-1A engines was operated on 100% SAF. The fuel, mainly derived from used cooking oil with other waste fats, was supplied by Total Energies. Initial results from the ground and flight tests are expected in 2022.